Alright, so we're pretty set up with the NURBS components of our chicken toy at this point. I just want to look at adding in the legs right now. Now, the legs, even though they look very rounded, I'm going to try and produce them from cubes to start off with. And we're going to look at using polygon geometry for building these, just for a bit of variety and technique. The main part about why I'm actually using polygons, though, is that polygons are going to allow me to arbitrarily change the direction of my topology, which is going to be very helpful as these feet start to split off. Well, to work with polygons, let's change our surfaces menu set back to the polygon menu set. In the shelves, let's also reset the shelves to the polygon shelf. And I'm going to create a polygon cube for my leg. But now we'll build one leg first, and then we'll duplicate the other leg over. In fact, when we're done, you're going to notice we're going to have to break the symmetry of this model just a little bit to make it work. The body's in a slightly different position and off to the side. The back leg is a little further back. But we'll build this and move it all at the end. I'm going to take my cube, and I'm going to bring it upwards and roughly put it into place underneath the leg. I'll grab the scale tool, scale it in, and the move tool, again, to reposition this. And I'll move it off to the side ever so slightly. And just sync it up inside of that body for now. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the bottom face component. I'll right-click on this and choose face. And select that bottom face. And using the move tool, I'm now going to move this down quite considerably. I'll maybe also move it back just a little bit. Now I know this is going to look very boxy compared to the rounded forms that we had before, but trust me, we're going to come in and we're going to smooth this out when we're done. It's just going to be easier to work with as simple a model as we can for as long as possible, and that's a good general guideline with this. Now what I want to do is I want to create new geometry around this form, and in fact, whenever you're working with a polygon model, it's helpful to try and keep your faces as square as possible. Now, these are quadrilateral faces. They have only four edges, but they're very rectangular. So I'm going to try and make these a little bit more square. And the bottom square I'm going to use to start to create some of these other elements for the feet. Well, let's come in here. Let's create this. I'm going to go into Edit Mesh, and I'm going to grab the Insert Edge Loop tool. This is actually very similar to the Insert Isopar method we used before, but watch some of the differences. When I select this tool, my cursor becomes a little triangle. It almost looks like the spaceship from Asteroids, the old Atari video game. And if I now click on an edge while holding down my left mouse button, I have this green dotted line, which is a potential new edge loop. You can actually think of edge loops very similar, in a very similar fashion to how you'd think of isoparms. And I've got a dotted line, which tells me where my potential edge loop is going to be. However, when I let go, that line becomes solid. There's no process of then going and inserting additional edge loops like you did with insert isoparms. When I click to create them, they're automatically there. So I'm going to create maybe two more here and then another one for the bottom. That's going to really help this out, I think. Well, one of the first things you'll notice about the foot is that it has this little back spur and three individual legs that come out from the base. Well, that base itself actually even widens in the front. Let's see what we can do to actually get this prepped. Like I said, this is going to widen in the front, so I'm going to select that face, grab the scale tool, and maybe even start to widen it out along this front section. The back face, maybe I can move that out just a little bit. To create that back spur, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the extrude the selected component command. If I have a face selected, it's going to extrude a face. If I have an edge selected, I'm going to extrude an edge. Now, for the process of our workflow today, where we start with a box and we continue modeling from there, you're going to want to extrude faces only. This is a technique obviously known as box modeling. There's a different technique which works in a similar fashion but uses edges to extrude. It doesn't usually start out with a box as well. Correspondingly, this technique is rather straightforwardly known as edge extrusion modeling. We're going to examine both of those techniques in a lot more detail in an upcoming video series. What I'm going to do now, though, is I'm going to select a face and hit extrude the selected component. You can find it on my shelf as this icon right here, or I can go to Edit Mesh and choose Extrude. And that will give me a manipulator tool. It's a universal manipulator. What I want to do is, with this, I can pull straight out of the face to create an extrusion. Notice how it extrudes straight off of the perpendicular direction of that face, which we refer to as the normal, which again we'll pay more attention to in later tutorials. This manipulator has rotate functionality, move functionality, and scale functionality built into it all at once. I can also switch the direction so that it's either associated with that perpendicular direction or by clicking on the head of this pin. There's no real technical name for it, so I've referred to it as the pin, and the little circle at the top is the head of the pin. By clicking on the head of the pin, I can actually toggle this to work off of world space coordinates as well, if that's how I would like to work with it. And I can scale these down, move it, and I think get a pretty good, pretty well-defined shape. I'll hit F8 to conclude, and that's my basic form. Now I do want to create actually three separate toes for the front. To do this, I've only got one face on the front right now. So what I'm going to do is go back to Edit Mesh and choose Insert Edge Loop. And I'm going to click to create two new edge loops for this form. I'm going to select these three faces along the bottom. Now I'm going to extrude out separate toes from these. If I currently hit extrude the selected component, it's going to essentially give me one big foot, which is not what I want. I want three separate toes. The reason this is happening is that under Edit Mesh, our Keep Faces Together button has been checked. Now, 9 times out of 10, you actually want this checked, and make sure that in most cases this is on. But where I want my faces to separate, I can click this, essentially unchecking it. And when I hit Extrude, you'll notice that as I move this out, my faces are actually going to be separated. Now, when I'm done here, I'm just going to come back in and turn Keep Faces Together back on, just in case my next extrusions warrant it. But I'll select all three using Shift, and with the Move tool, I will move these out. Grab the Rotate tool and pull these far ones out to the side. And I'll move that far piece back just a little bit. To create the top of a foot, I'm just going to select this center edge and move it forward and up a little bit. And that's going to round this out. Now again, like I said, I want to try and keep my faces a little bit more square if I can. So I'm going to get Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool, and just cut maybe 2 edge loops per toe. And then maybe one along the back. That's going to give you a very nice base for this foot. In the next video, we're going to look at smoothing and softening this out and creating the duplicate foot.